I'll have the prime rib and the sociopath here will have the pasta from the children's menu.
Very good, sir.
Oh, I like those glasses. But I can hardly see you, though.
That's the point.
I wear contacts.
And that's how I can see right through you.
You don't have to order for me. I'm not a child.
That was a clip from the new movie, The Mimic, that shows the lighter side, the funny side of sociopaths. Yes, I said that. And the star of the movie, Thomas Sadoski, is here to talk about it. Tommy, good to see you.
Hi, Lisa. How are you?
Hi, I'm great. So, The Mimic, yeah.
Yes.
Okay. The acting is incredible. You're incredible in it. You know, like, it really shows how actors really can work off of each other. But my question is, why? Why this movie? This is really out there. Why?
It is a completely unique experience, right? Like, you have not seen a movie like this before, which is hard to say these days, you know? I mean, in a lot of ways, you sort of feel like, you know, film and entertainment can sort of get into these tropes and can start to feel a little bit recycled. That's part of the reason I wanted to do this movie, because when I read the script, I had never read anything like this. It's literary, you know, meaning that it travels fast. There's a lot of words crunched into the hour and a half of movie time, and the story is utterly unique. It's very weird, and it's really fun. Like, you come out of it going like, I just journeyed through the mind of two madmen, but in a really gentle way. You know what I mean? Like, this isn't like watching a Dateline episode from inside the episode of the from inside the mind of the killer. You know what I mean? It's a lot more fun than that. And it is based on a true story. This really happened to Tom Mazziotti, who wrote and directed it. And, you know, he has a very, I guess, what would be like a very puckish sort of worldview and sense of humor. And so you just get this very odd movie with a lot of really talented actors.
I was like, oh my gosh, I know that person. There's a lot of these pop up, and they're like, wait, what is she doing in this movie? But my question is when you read this script, because I found myself watched the whole movie, and I was like, midway through, I was like, what the hell am I watching? And then and then at the end, I was like, I can't stop thinking about what is this movie? It's like, you cannot put it in a box. It doesn't make sense anywhere. I mean, it's funny, and the dialogue is fantastic, but when you read the script, were you like, WTF, what is this?
That's pretty much exactly what my experience of it was. It was like, I have no idea how we're going to make this, what it's going to look like, what the experience is going to be like, but I do know that I'm going to be entertained, and it is going to be an utterly unique experience, unlike anything I've ever done before. And it absolutely ticked all of those boxes for me.
And, you know, and I was reading that it is, you know, like a real true indie film, and you guys shot this thing in something like 18 days. Is that right?
18 days. Yeah. We had one rehearsal for like 2 hours, 3 hours. And then we showed up on set and we just started making it. And then every once in a while, you know, Jessica Walter would roll in, Mary Lou Henner would roll in, Austin Pendleton, Gina Gershon, you know, all these extraordinary people would just sort of roll in, shoot a scene with us. And then, you know, we'd say, see you later. And we'd just keep on cranking.
Now, the other thing I want to ask you, because I know you guys shot this a while ago. I think it was like in 2017, right?
Yeah, 3 years ago. Yeah.
Yep. So, and I think you, at that point, I think your daughter was a newborn, was she not?
Yes, she was. She was.
A dad with a newborn in the house get to work and like spit out that dialogue with me? I don't understand. I was watching and thinking to myself, holy crap, he had a baby at home at the time. I couldn't remember half of those words.
Yeah, I think that the fact that we're, like I said, sort of gently journeying through the mind of madmen definitely helped. Like the lack of sleep that I was sort of operating under, and, you know, getting back home and trying to take care of the baby and be as much help as I possibly could, you know, after 12 hours on set, it was, it helped in the sort of keep me, you know, off off kilter a little bit, which I felt like is exactly where I needed to be for the film.
Yeah. Okay. We just mentioned your kids. You have two beautiful babies and your beautiful wife, Amanda. So I was watching it randomly, was watching Jimmy Kimmel about a month ago. It was her birthday. It was your birthday. It was, she was on Jimmy Kimmel on her birthday, but she was talking about your birthday.
Yes.
Where she was in the woods in a bear costume to scare you.
Yeah.
And my question is did you get back at her and scare her for her birthday?
No, I have not. That is, first of all, the bear costume thing was so good that it's going to take me a long, she's incredibly creative in terms of that sort of stuff. I'm not nearly as good as she is when it comes to that. So it's going to take me a long time to think about like a way to get proper revenge. The hamster wheel is very slowly turning up here, trying to get it going. Yeah.
You have a lot bigger things going on. Of course, she, for another film role that she was in, is getting all kinds of Oscar buzz. So congratulations to her and to you on that. And also congratulations on the wild ride that is The Mimic.
Thank you.
It is available today. You can see it in the movie theater, but you can also just, VOD from your house, download it and watch it at home.
It is available on iTunes, video on demand. And I think there are some movie theaters that are showing it too, if you live in a place where that's happening.
Where that can be a thing. All right, Tommy, have a great day on set and we will talk to you soon.
Thank you.